Here I'll show you a few more advanced skills when it comes to viewing VCFs in IGV. To cover these topics, we're going to use a VCF file with variant data on chromosome 22 from about 850 people from all around the world. And IGV is going to help us find interesting patterns in this data. Let's begin. As you can see, our data is already loaded. At the top are the variant sites represented with colored allele fraction bars. In the middle are the sample genotypes for each variant site. And on the left, we can see some of our 850 samples. Now, as I mentioned before, these samples are from people all over the world. To tell us what sample is from where, I have a file which lists the population, superpopulation, and gender of each sample. To find population-based patterns, I'm going to need to get this information into IGV. But how am I going to do that? Well, IGV has this great feature where if the user loads a text file with information corresponding to preloaded samples, the information will appear as annotations next to the samples. Note that this file needs to be a tab-delimited text file with matching sample names in the first column. So let's try it out. And nothing happened. Actually, we need to tell IGV to show the sample annotations we loaded by going to View and selecting Show Attribute Display. Awesome. Now we can see the population, superpopulation, and gender of all of our samples. If we hover over the annotations, we can see the values the colors correspond to. If you decide there's an annotation you don't want to see, for example, I don't think this sample annotation is useful, you can remove it by going to View, Select Attributes to Show, and deselecting the one you don't want. So now that we see the sample annotations we want, we can start looking for patterns. But to do that, we need to be able to see all of our samples. We can do this by right-clicking and setting the display mode to squished. Now we see all of our 850 samples. Let's first look for variant patterns based on superpopulation. To find these patterns, we need to be able to group the samples in the same superpopulation together. To do this, we use the appropriately named Group By tool by right-clicking Group By and selecting the annotation to group the samples by. Let's select Superpopulation. When we do this, each of our superpopulations gets a section of data. These superpopulations are European, East Asian, Mixed American, South Asian, and African. If we zoom in and start scrolling through the data, we notice that most variants occur at a similar frequency across the superpopulations. But look at this variant. It looks like this variant occurs almost exclusively in the African population. If we click on the allele frequency bar, we can see that this variant occurs 61% of the time in the African population and about 4% of the time in the mixed American population. Using this variant's name in the pop-up menu, a quick Google search reveals that this variant is indeed found almost exclusively in people with African ancestry and is strongly associated with kidney disease. That begs the question, if this variant plays a role in causing kidney disease, why is it so common in Africans? This paper, published in Science magazine in 2010, shows that the APOL1 protein with this mutant allele can kill the parasite that causes the deadly African sleeping sickness. So even though this variant may cause kidney disease, it was still selected for in Africa because it protected its carrier from sleeping sickness. Once you've found a variant that interests you, like this one, IGV lets you sort the samples according to their status at this variant. For example, if I right-click and select Sort by Genotype, IGV is going to sort the samples according to their genotype at this variant within each superpopulation. With this view, I can see that the heterozygous genotype is slightly more common than the homozygous genotype. And I can see that this variant seems to occur equally often in males and females. So just like we grouped superpopulations and found this interesting variant, we can do the same with our other sample annotations, like gender or population.